Welcome to RSS DI TV 2020. I am Dr. Shahu Ingole and you are watching me on RSS DI TV 2020 brought to you by WOCARD. Today, I am honored to have with me an eminent personality, a renowned senior endocrinologist from Ahmedabad, Dr. Rucha Mehta ma'am. Ma'am is a senior endocrinologist, Edmo Clinic, Ahmedabad. Welcome to the show, ma'am. So, ma'am, we would like to know from you what a diabeticity is and does obesity leads to diabetes or it's a vice versa?
Great. Thank you, Dr. Shahu. I think that's a very burning question and that will be the topic of discussion, you know, when we do the RSSDI 2020, and it was a burning topic even at the American Diabetes Association and the European Association for Diabetes. So it's sort of like the chicken and the egg story, as you rightfully asked, what comes first? Is it diabetes or is it obesity? So we do know that diabetes has a very strong familial tendency. If your parents have it, you have more than a 40% chance of getting it. So certainly you cannot ignore the genetic background. And we are talking about type 2 diabetes prematurely, of course. Of course, that is really the big elephant in the room all the time. Now, how is obesity linked to this? We know from several studies, including the ICMR India DIAB study, so even from our very own Indian data, that obesity is the leading or the main driver for type 2 diabetes. Dr. Ramachandran and his colleagues in the South, when they did the study, what they found is that from the 1980s to 2000, obesity maybe went up by 4 or 5 folds, but diabetes went up exponentially along with this. So we have clear data indicating that obesity is somehow intricately linked to the rising prevalence of diabetes. And therefore, I think it's a nice topic we've selected today. We would like to combine them and call it diabesity. Because we may ignore sometimes that we need to treat obesity way before you develop diabetes, way before you develop heart disease, way before you develop blood pressure. So I think that's sort of what I would like to focus upon as to why are we even talking about this term we have come up with called diabesity.
Okay. So, ma'am, according to you, what is the key for the prevention of diabetes and the obesity?
So, certainly, since we are saying obesity is the main driver of type 2 diabetes, it behooves us to think, can we prevent diabetes by sort of treating obesity? Now, we know there are no effective medical treatments for obesity. And the most important thing that works, the pillar of treatment, is lifestyle management. So this would sort of revolve around diet and activity and exercise. Diet being 80% and physical activity being about 20%. We have several studies. Again, I would like to refer to the big one that sort of got us all thinking was the Look Ahead trial. And it was probably the first trial that was sort of trying to see if we combined an intensive lifestyle intervention, can we prevent or can we reverse type 2 diabetes? And we were very surprised and excited to see that the intensive lifestyle worked very, very well compared to usual counseling. So along those lines, we had several programs, one being the diabetes prevention program in the US. Then we have our very own Indian diabetes prevention program, along with several studies such as the Finnish diabetes project and the Ducking study. Now, all of these have gone on to show that different lifestyle interventions do work. Now, what they've also shown us is that if you fail to maintain these lifestyle interventions, the diabetes comes back. Dr. Shahu, most recently, we had jaw-dropping evidence from something known as the DIRECT trial, which was done by Dr. Roy Taylor and colleagues in the UK, for the very first time using a dietary intervention of a very low-calorie diet to reverse type 2 diabetes. And even those results look very promising. So certainly, to answer your question, my take-home message would be, yes, think about obesity as a disease. You need to be screening for it just like you screen for diabetes. You need to really target treating this before we develop complications or morbidities related to obesity, which could be fatty liver, polycystic ovaries, diabetes, pre-diabetes, and even cancer and increased chance of strokes, mortality, and heart disease. Number three take-home message would be, the pillar stones of treatment are, of course, lifestyle management, but we now have certain effective treatments. We may use metformin, which was used in some of these trials. We have certain data with or suggestions with pioglitazone. Of course, it's not a very favorite drug in India. Number three, we have suggestions from the stop NIDDM trial with Ekar Bose, along with even newer data for the GLP-1 analog. So we have some exciting new products in the pipeline, and hopefully it won't just boil down to, you know, not eating, which is very hard for us Indians to do, of course, but also including physical activity and a balanced lifestyle approach is what I will say.
Okay, so we would like to know from you, what is your opinion regarding the diabetes remission or diabetes reversal, and to what extent the aggressive management of the obesity can play a role?
So I can see you're completely in tune with the latest data. You're asking us about diabetes reversal, which I sort of just mentioned when I spoke about Dr. Roy Taylor's study. All of this data, very interestingly, we started thinking about this, that can you reverse diabetes, from the bariatric surgery data. So metabolic surgery, as we now like to call it preferably, showed that when patients lost, you know, tremendous amounts of weight, their diabetes seemed to go away. So this made us think, how about, can we not achieve this just simply by a non-surgical approach using medications or lifestyle? And yes, it has been exciting to see from the direct trial that when patients lost 15 kilograms or more, we could see the fat moving out of their liver and the pancreas, and almost a 97% chance of reversing type 2 diabetes. So the key number seems to be 15 kilograms. Most of our guidelines like to say that if you're trying to reverse, reduce number of medications, the key and easy number to remember is 7 to 10% of weight loss. So yes, certainly reversal of type 2 diabetes is becoming not a myth anymore, it's becoming a reality. I think the predictors for success will be a younger age whenever from diagnosis. So if you are less than 10 years from diagnosis, which enables us to have functional beta cells. Number two is the lesser number of medications. Generally, we say insulin-requiring patients, we may have a harder.
So thank you so much, Dr. Rucha ma'am, for joining us on RSSBI TV and sharing your views. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you.
And wish you a good meeting.